How do you see so far the demeanor of the Senate under President Rodrigo Duterte? Has it been independent as it should be?
No, it has not been as independent as it should be.
Why?
Well, I can see by their behavior that, or what they don't do when they don't speak out, that they're kind of wary of fighting the president. Now, maybe that's just because this is an election year, so I don't know. We'll see next year. But still, in the Senate, you lack enough independent voices. You really do.
But how about, let's say, during the first 2.5 years? Because now it's the election season.
Yeah.
But during the first year, perhaps they would say honeymoon period, new president.
Yeah.
But how about in between?
I don't know. We have to see. You see, after this election, we're now in the election period. So you're talking about the honeymoon period, the first 2 years, the election period in the third year. So we really have to find out what it is that they're going to do in the next 3 years.
Should it change after 2019 when you have a new composition in the Senate?
I don't know. It all depends. People may change, people may not change, so I don't know.
Yeah, but should it change in terms of being more independent?
Definitely it should change. Definitely there should be more independent voices in the Senate. Definitely there should be people speaking out against certain issues on which they normally would not speak out. They would just keep quiet, and that's not good, because the Senate is needed as a check and balance on whoever is in power.
Yeah, precisely, because I think there's also concern raised by members of the opposition slate. They say that you cannot allow a Senate, this election, the all 12 slots occupied by the president's candidates or supporters, because what would that make of the next Senate?
That's right. That is that's absolutely correct.
Yeah.
They should not choose it on the basis of who are the president's candidates or who are not the president's candidates.
Now, in terms of things that this Senate failed to do, what do you think was the most glaring?
I really don't know. I haven't been paying that close attention to matters in the Senate. But there have been things that have happened that I wish they had reacted earlier.
Example, there are other glaring issues before. Example, the drug war.
Yes.
Some people were saying that the Senate should make a more definitive stand against that issue. Of course, there was a resolution that came. But again, it seemed that they waited for so long.
Yeah.
And also the issue of the Sereno impeachment. There was an impression that why allow the House to get its way? Diba tinanggal si Sereno, not through impeachment, when in fact that should have been done under the auspices of the Senate as an impeachment court.
Yeah. But they did a shortcut, and they succeeded in getting the shortcut done, so they got Sereno out the easy way.